Hello, welcome. My name is Jan Telman and I will tell you something about multivariable optimization. When we have a racing driver who requires an amount of 200 kilowatts, the question is how can we reach that? There are a number of factors influencing this. For instance, fuel amount, the amount of air, the pressure of air, the time of ignition. All those factors will influence the result. What is the optimal setting of all those factors to reach the required 200 kilowatts? We see multivariable optimization in a lot of fields in the engineering. Another example I have here. This is an example for teaching. Imagine we have a client who asks us to shoot 200 centimeters, 2 meters with this gear. This gear has a lot of variables, factors, which can be adjusted. Another example of multivariable optimization. What will be the optimal settings to reach the client's requirements of shooting 2 meters? Let's do some screening experiments. To get some feeling for the operation of our system, we will do some trials at reasonable settings of all the variables. So we shoot some times and we will record the results. Try it at the maximum. So it's 201. Just another try. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah. So we performed a couple of experiments on reasonable levels of our factors, and what we saw was that the results are about 2 meters, so we are happy with that. But when we look at the curve, the motion of the balls, it is very flat, and from engineering judgment we think it's better to have a nice curve for more accuracy of our results. What we need then is that we have an earlier stopping point of our arm of this catapult, so putting it here. But as you can see now, then we do not have that much stroke to adjust our distance. So to optimize, we need another brainstorm for just adjusting our system. We just changed our system a bit. We felt we needed a slope of our catapult, and we found a solution to make this slope so that we have more stroke to reach our required distance. All the other factors are still as they were, and for the next step we will think how to change our factors in order to find the optimum solution. In our team, we discussed what factors could influence the results with this system. The first one is the cup. It can be positioned here, but also on different other positions. The next one is the lever angle. Here there is some markings that says it can be 140, 170. So the lever angle is our second factor. Then we have the stopper position. That's this one. It can be put on different levels, making the movement short or longer, which will influence the motion. Then we have the pin position. That's this one. It can be put on 4 levels, A to D, and that will influence the the strength of the bend. Another factor influencing the result possibly is the ball weight. As you can see, we have different balls, a very light one, a quite heavy one. Then we have the rubber band, which is of a special type. Different types of rubber bands can also influence the result. Also, we have the band routing. As you can see, it can be done in a number of ways. You can do it like this, but also you can do it like this. So we have different ways to route the band. Of course, we can add an extra band. So the number of bands, this one or two, can also be an influencing factor. Just another factor is the band position, which is just indicated here. The band position can be varied from A to E, and now it's on A, and when you change this, you can put it on C, just giving another effect on our experiments. So in the previous step, our team just discussed a number of possible factors. We came up with this long list of up to 9 factors. This will be time consuming to do an experiment with all those factors. Which of the factors can be fixed? Which one do we not need to investigate? So then we came up that the cup position can be fixed. So we will not vary that in our experiment. The same is with the ball weight. Also, the bend type is not reasonable to vary, because also in practice it will be difficult to switch from types. The routing will also be fixed, and finally also the number of bends. This means that after this step we just made from our long list a short list of possible influencing factors, which are the angle, the stop position, the pin position and the bend position. Our team came up with an operating window for the different control factors as stated here. Before going to the big experiment, we tried to whether this operating window will work. At first we aimed at a maximum distance, and we did it by choosing an angle of 180 and these levels of the other factors. When we tried this, we came up to 340 centimeters, which is good. Then we tried to choose the combinations which will give a minimum distance. So we choose 140, B, A and B. And when we tried that, we didn't shoot either, because our distance was less than zero. The ball was just dropping down. 140 is not a good setting. This will not work. Then we just tried, okay, what will be the reasonable minimum which will give a reasonable result? And then we found that it would be 155. And we tried that, and we came up to a distance of about 20 centimeters. And that's okay for having a good operating window. So from this step, we are ready to perform our big experiment, and that will be the next step. Well, now we are ready to set up our experiment in Minitop. So we will design our experiment. It's also called design of experiments. What we do then is that we first choose the design, which is going with start DOA factorial, create factorial design. We have a number of factors, which is 4. We made a short list of 4 factors. What we have to do then is that we define our factors. We know them already, because they are the angle, which is factor number A, the angle, the stop position, pin position, bend position. No, now we have to choose our operating window. The angle was from 155 to 180. I have now have designed my experiments in telling Minitab what factors we have and on what levels they will be varied. Choose not to randomize the runs, just give the runs in standard order. When I click on OK, I get my experiment with 16 runs, just telling me for every run what should be the settings for the four factors: angle, stop, pin and bend position. Now we are ready to collect our results. Okay. Now we put the stop on B, the pin on A, the bend on B.
Okay, number 55.
Yes.
Five.
Okay.
61.
All right. At this point, we performed all our experiments and we just recorded the results in the distance variable. Now we have to find out what settings are needed to achieve a given goal. So let's do the analysis to find out which of our factors have influence on the distance. I go to Stat, do factorial analysis of factorial design. My response is the distance. My terms are just the main effects and possible interactions. And I choose for OK. And I see the Pareto chart of the effects. And as we see in the Pareto charts, all the factors have an effect. That will our short list of four factors show a big effect on the distance. The factor A, as coded by Minitab, which is the angle, has the largest effect, followed by the stop, and so on. You can see it in the chart. We are happy from this moment because our short list shows to work. Every factor from the short list has an effect on the distance. Now we have to find out what effects are, and we can see it by the graph, which is called the factorial plot. When I make the factorial plots, I can show you that I make a chart of the main effects, and this shows what the effects are for the different control factors. You see positive effects of angle, stop and pin, and a negative effect of the bend position. And also we can look at the interactions. And interactions are very common in multivariable optimization. This one shows you that, for instance, the effect of angle is dependent on the setting of the pin. What we did up to now is that we found which factors have an effect and how big this effect is. When you know this, you can use it to predict what are suitable settings to achieve a goal like 220 centimeters. Stat, do factorial response optimizer. I tell him, please optimize the distance to a target of 220. From this chart, we can see that the optimal settings are C for the stop, D for the pin, B for the bend, and 169 for the angle. We are very curious because these settings we did not try in our experiment so far, but we will try this now. So guys, let's give it a try. Yes. Yes. Yo.
Yes.
Experience.
Kijk, dit is 60, man.
Je kan het, jongen. This is exactly what we predicted from our experiments. Every ball was hitting the target of 220 centimeters. We can just do it for 1.5 meter or 2.5 meter and every target in between. But what when the customer will narrow his specifications like this? The specs are now plus or minus 5 centimeters. That will be your challenge. And please upload the success of your results.